Patience. That's what we're going to be talking about today on Manna Minutes. Stay tuned. You know, if you can wait that long. Hello, Manna Minutes fans. Thank you for joining me today. And yeah, we're going to be talking about patience again. I know we've already talked about it once, and we're going to talk about it again. And if you'd like to move on to something new, then just be patient. And yeah, I know you probably fast-forwarded through the intro, didn't you? Huh? Yeah. You think I don't know, but again, you know, just playing on the odds of statistical probabilities. Hey, remember to come out and join us this Sunday. We are having another installment of Stronger Together. It's going to be fantastic. If you're missing out on that, you're really missing out on something. Not because of me, not because of Brother Dwight or Brother Phil, but because we are working in the Word of God through the power of the Holy Spirit to function as a unified body. And that's something worth investing our patience in, right? Well, today we're actually going to be jogging over to the book of James. Okay, we'll walk instead because that demonstrates patience. But we're going to be in the book of James today, chapter 5, verses 7 through 11. Let's read it. Good idea. Be patient, therefore, brothers, until the coming of the Lord. See how the farmer waits for the precious fruit of the earth, being patient about it until it receives the early and the late rains. You also be patient. Establish your hearts, for the coming of the Lord is at hand. Do not grumble against one another, brothers, so that you may not be judged. Behold, the judge is standing at the door. As an example of suffering and patience, brothers, take the prophets who spoke in the name of the Lord. Behold, we consider those blessed who remain steadfast. You have heard of the steadfastness of Job, and you have seen the purpose of the Lord, how the Lord is compassionate and merciful. This is just as much of the book of James, so tremendously power-packed that in a short segment like this, we're barely going to be able to touch the surface. But nonetheless, we are going to, right? And it talks about, you know, see how the farmer waits for the precious fruit of the earth, being patient about it, you know, the former and latter rains. We have just read through that, right? But I want to share with you this thought, right? Think about a mushroom. A mushroom will pop up overnight. But, I mean, you don't build your house out of a mushroom unless you're a Smurf. But we don't build our houses out of mushrooms, you know. But if you want to get a good, solid piece of lumber, that's going to take some time to grow. It's going to take some time to develop that. And I know a lot of times in our lives, we do have the mushroom mentality. We have the microwave mentality, you know. This should just happen, just bang, overnight, right? And sure, we'd all love for the big miracles to take place, for God to just come and deliver you out of everything all at once. But sometimes we need to remember that sudden onset growth also brings with it its own set of problems. I mean, really, if you had $1 million in the bank right now, think about it. Let's be honest. Would you really do much good for yourself? Or is there a pretty good chance that, you know, you might run amok just a little bit? I don't know. I think about it. You know, I think about what would I do if I had $1 million right now in the bank? Yeah, well, the first thing I'd do is give 10% to the Lord. Well, congratulations on that. But what are you going to do with the other 90%, huh? Right? Listen, here's the fact. And if we look at a principle like that, it all belongs to the Lord. And the Lord is working things for your good and for your benefit. He is trying to establish wonderful purposes in your life. And we could have went a lot of different places in the scripture. I mean, the scripture is just full of the stuff about patience. And we could have went to even Psalm 27, you know, that ends up there with be patient and wait upon the Lord. Wait, I say, upon the Lord. And we take a look at a man like Job. And, you know, if that isn't a real challenge, And sometimes it's very difficult for us to be patient in the growth process. Difficult to be patient with children. Difficult to be patient in relationships. Difficult to be patient when you're studying and when education is in play. It's difficult to be patient in all the areas of our lives, but it is absolutely vital and necessary. And I'm going to bring this one piece out here in verse 8. Establish your hearts, for the coming of the Lord is at hand. Now, this would almost seem like an out-of-place statement unless we begin to understand the purposes and the work of God. Do you understand that God wants you to have your heart established? You know, the prophets, and we can look at that because in this passage it says, take a look at the prophets. Did you ever think about the life of Joseph? Did it almost seem unfair, the amount of time that he had to spend in slavery and in prison? You think about Job, how it almost seems unfair? What about the nation of Israel? All those years they spent in slavery and then the years in the desert. Does it ever seem unfair? God has his perfect work that he is trying to perfect in you. All these things that he's bringing into your life, he's laying on layers, doing refinement work. And sometimes the very little tedious things, when they have finished their good and perfect work, are going to be the very building blocks that God is going to use to magnify his glory in your life. Think about something with me. In the best perception that we can take, Jesus was about 30 years old when he started his earthly ministry, right? His public ministry. He spends about 3 years in ministry. Do you realize that's 10 to 1? I mean, basically, he spent 10 years of just living life on planet Earth for every 1 year that he spent in ministry. That's a significant investment in time. So just give that a consideration. Sometimes when we are wanting to urge God to move on, and God is saying, just relax and enjoy the day in front of you. And we're going to wrap up with that. This is the day that the Lord has made. So rejoice and be glad in it, even if it takes patience, right? Hey, it's been Manna Minutes. I'm Brother Daniel. Remember, be good, have fun, do it in that order. Lord bless you today. And be patient. He is working on it to bless you. Have you ever held a doubt what this life is all about? Have you questioned all this is?